it's okay to dream dreams, and it's okay to dream big dreams, and it's okay to set your goals even far in excess of what others or even you yourself might convince you that are possible.
This community is an exceptionally ambitious community which is willing to put a lot of resources into succeeding in the area of the arts, recognizing that this is the ticket to greatness.
We're going to create a great city here on the foundation of this Woodruff Arts Center.
It has become a symbol of hope, and it anchors the arts in this city, in this state, perhaps even in this region. And we must expand upon that.
I see the Robert Woodruff statue every day. When I go to class, I can't help but see it. And when I first got to this institution, I kept wondering why it is that this man, this founder of Coca-Cola, would be so involved with the arts, why he would generate something so fantastic as the Woodruff Arts Center.
It's terribly important to have a strong arts movement and a strong arts organization in a city so that the citizens developed being whole men and women.
I began to suddenly like Robert Woodruff in a lot of ways. I feel like this is a man who had a vision.
The arts is not simply about decorating the world or entertaining the world. It's really about enriching the world. And that's something that must be shared. It's a commitment and an obligation we all have to each other.
If one believes that the life of the mind is important and integrity of intellectual disciplines and such are important, then one has to create an environment in which this can happen. If one grants the possibility of a creator, then one also has to grant, it seems to me, the possibility that creation is still continuing. Civilizations pass on to us their most important and their most beautiful produce, and I think it behooves us to pass that on to further generations.
Art allows us to see maybe ourselves a little better, or it allows to see others that we don't know that much about.
I think arts in general will make us a better person. It will enrich our lives. Will enrich the life of our children.
Constant hand of man reaching to touch his fellow man only with kindness, only with affection, only with love.
Art is actually, when it comes down to it, is the ultimate expression by man of his life.
The arts, I think, in some ways, are about freedom. They're not about the limits, but rather about what's beyond those limits.
For me, conducting an orchestra and being on stage and hear this glorious music coming at you and to be able to maneuver it and to lead it and to make it so exciting that sometimes you feel like you create some supernatural presence on stage.
If you're watching a play and it's in a performance where that actor is giving everything he has, and it touches something because it reminds you of something happened in your life, you can't buy that anywhere. That's something you have to treasure.
It's a heightened form of living. In a short time with the arts, we can give our souls experience that would take maybe years to gain as we go along our everyday lives.
I always loved the idea of somebody could be 6 feet away from me, pretending they were somebody else and really change the way I feel about something. That's a miracle to me. They really can change the way you feel, and just by what they do and say and those shadows up there.
Everybody needs a place where they can go and let this happen to them.
This Woodruff Arts Center is a remarkable place. You've got four different ideas going on here. You've got the symphony, you've got the theater, you've got the High Museum, you've got the Atlanta College of Art right here.
The Woodruff Arts Center represents what this city could be, what it should be. It's a living institution that folk from all over our city and all over our state can come to this institution to be fed.
More than 2 million people a year have a direct interaction with some art form of the Woodruff Arts Center. And of those 2 million people, 250,000 are youngsters who are involved in one way or another in the educational activities of the divisions here. And of course, arts education has a kind of magical intensity to it that just causes young people to get really involved and to want to learn.
We have a five-year-old little granddaughter that comes to the family concerts, and we came one Saturday not long ago, and she was wiggling and moving around like all of the children. But when the orchestra started playing a certain piece, she looked at me and she says, "That's our music, isn't it?" And I thought, that's what it's all about.
There's nothing more beautiful than hope in the eyes of a kid, and they're looking up and it's like, I'm just glad to be alive. I'm just thankful to be here. And it's like,
each one of the divisions has a children's program that works. And you never know when you turn that flame on for a child who becomes an artist, takes serious music, or becomes interested in the theater.
Our kids are our future. The city depends on the future of our children. Through developing of the arts and education, we will definitely make this city a better city.
If you're going to have a city of world renown, you got to have the culture of world renown to go with it.
We in Atlanta have now for 25 years claimed to be the world's next great city. We have not been. We have had thrust upon us with the great fortune of the Olympic victory, the opportunity to become just that.
Come 1996, the eyes of the world are going to be in the city of Atlanta. And we will be able to show to the world in 2 short weeks what this city is all about.
When you can't just build buildings and say, look, we got a great city here, you got to have a heartbeat and a pulse, and that's what the arts are.
More and more in the area of economic development and in the area of industrial recruitment, these people are interested in the quality of life that a community offers.
It used to be that if you came from Atlanta, it was oh. But now it's oh, because word has gotten around about our museum, our symphony, and our theater.
The future is absolutely here in Atlanta.
This is the story of Atlanta, the way the various parts of the city have worked together for prosperity. The Woodruff Arts Center is simply a great example of that, and the great leaders have rallied to it.
In keeping with Mr. Woodruff's vision, the Robert W. Woodruff Foundation has made a commitment, or has made a grant of $10 million, provided that $20 million of unrestricted funds are gathered from the rest of the community and other donors.
Nothing is more important than building a solid foundation, and that's what this $30 million endowment will do for this center.
I ask everyone to join us in reaching that goal and achieving that objective.
We will be one of the major art centers of this world in time, and we have to dream to get there.
Great civilization, when great cities were built, those who were economically and intellectually gifted devoted 90% of their time to public service.
Mr. Woodruff was one of the world's true visionaries. He could see this.
Mr. Woodruff had a dream. I think the leadership now, at this particular time, has to implement that vision and implement those dreams.
I think the people of Atlanta almost have an obligation to continue what he's done for us.
I don't see this community letting Mr. Woodruff down, nor letting ourselves down. From this beginning, we'll grow a great endowment for the arts in our community. And so as we follow in the footsteps, the very large footsteps of Mr. Woodruff, so must we leave footprints for those who will follow us.
It just simply is the business of society to take care of the arts. We are a young society, and that's why we need a few elders, like any church needs elders, to grab the community by the shirt and shake them and say, look, these things are important. It's not because it's good for business, but because it's a part of being human.